Scholastic Audio presents The Puppy Place, Pugsley, by Ellen Miles. Read for you by Eliza Foss. Chapter 1. Dogs, dogs, dogs. Everywhere Lizzie Peterson looked, she saw dogs. Huge dogs and tiny dogs, curly-haired dogs and long-eared dogs, and dogs with big fluffy tails. There were dogs that barked and dogs that whined, and dogs that ran across the floor with their toenails clicking and their mouths wide open in huge doggy smiles. Lizzie was in heaven. She didn't know which dog to hug first, which one to pat, which one to tell, "Good dog." So she tried to do it all. She leaned over to hug a big, gentle shepherd mix, held out a hand to pat the bushy nose of a white and brown terrier, and said, "Happy birthday, Max," to the goofy black lab who had brought over a stuffed clown to show her. It was Max's birthday. He was turning 2, and Lizzie had been helping to set up a doggy birthday party for him. "You sure do love dogs," said the woman standing next to Lizzie. "I sure do," Lizzie said, reaching out to pat another dog who had run over to visit. Lizzie smiled up at her Aunt Amanda, the owner of Bowser's backyard. Aunt Amanda was tall and thin, with long, curly red hair. She didn't look much at all like Lizzie's dad, even though she was his little sister. Aunt Amanda and her husband, Uncle James, had lived in California for the last 10 years, so Lizzie had hardly ever met them, except at one family reunion. Of course, Lizzie had heard lots of stories about dog-crazy Amanda, but she'd never had a chance to get to know her aunt. That is, not until Aunt Amanda and Uncle James had moved to Littleton. Aunt Amanda had just opened her dream business, a doggy daycare, and it wasn't far from Lizzie's house. "And dogs love you, too," her aunt added now. "I can see that. You really have a way with animals." Lizzie felt like she might burst with happiness. Coming from Aunt Amanda, that meant a lot. Lizzie had been stopping by Bowser's backyard at least once a week since it had opened. It was the first doggy daycare business in Littleton. At first, Lizzie wasn't even sure what doggy daycare was. Aunt Amanda had explained that it was a place where people could bring their dogs for the day. The dogs could play safely there all day and get to know other dogs. Then their owners didn't have to leave them home alone while they, the people, that is, went to work. With the help of her staff, Amanda cared for up to 30 dogs a day, including her own dogs. She and Uncle James had 2 adorable pugs named Lionel and Jack, plus a sweet old golden retriever named Bowser. Lizzie had never known a pug before, but as soon as she met Lionel and Jack, she understood why Aunt Amanda was pug crazy, as she called it. The 2 pugs were like little brown bundles of energy, with flat, wrinkly faces and curly corkscrew tails. And they were cuddly, too. They were the funniest, cutest dogs Lizzie had ever met. Lizzie liked to talk about dogs, any kind of dogs, not just pugs, with Aunt Amanda. Of course, her aunt already knew all about how Lizzie and her family took care of puppies that needed homes. They kept them only until they found the perfect forever home for each one. The Petersons love being a foster family. Lizzie also told Aunt Amanda about how she volunteered once a week at Caring Paws, the animal shelter. One day, Lizzie worked up the courage to ask Aunt Amanda for a job. "I have lots of experience," she'd said. "I know a lot about dogs, but there's a lot more I want to learn." Lizzie knew she was too young for a real job. But even a 4th grader like her could be a lot of help when it came to taking care of 30 dogs. "I'll do anything," she had said. "You don't even have to pay me. I just want to be here." "And I love having you here," Aunt Amanda had said. "You're a big help. How about this? We'll start with 1 afternoon a week. Once we see how things work out, maybe you can come more often." And now, on Lizzie's very first day, Aunt Amanda was smiling at Lizzie and telling her what a good job she was already doing. "I can see you'll be a good helper, Lizzie. I may even need you to come up to Camp Bowser with me one weekend," if we have a lot of campers. Camp Bowser? Lizzie couldn't believe her ears. Ever since she had first heard about Camp Bowser, Lizzie had wanted to go there. What could be more fun than a sleepaway camp for dogs? When Aunt Amanda and Uncle James had moved from California, they'd also bought a cabin in the country. Every weekend, they took 5 or 6 dogs along when they went up to their country place. The dogs could run around in a big fenced area, swim in the brook, or even do arts and crafts, just like kids at a regular camp. Going to Camp Bowser would be, well, it would be the best thing that ever happened to Lizzie. Well, maybe the best thing next to getting Buddy. Lizzie smiled as she thought of the little brown puppy that had come to live with her family. The Petersons had fostered lots of puppies, and Lizzie and her brothers, Charles and the Bean, whose real name was Adam, had wanted to keep every single one. But Mom and Dad said that the Petersons weren't ready for a full-time dog. The Bean was just a toddler, and he needed lots of attention. Plus, Mom was more of a cat person. Then Buddy came along. The Petersons were caring for 4 dogs at that time. Lizzie had met a mother dog named Skipper, plus her 3 puppies, Cinnamon, Coco, and Buddy, at the shelter. Cinnamon and Coco, the girl puppies, were very cute, and Lizzie was thrilled when they found forever homes. But it was different with Buddy. Buddy was special. He was a small puppy, the runt of his litter. He needed lots of love and attention. Everyone fell in love with Buddy. Lizzie, Charles, the Bean, Dad, and even, especially, Mom. And when the time came to find Buddy a forever home, the Petersons all agreed that he would stay right there with them. Now, Buddy was a part of the family. Buddy had gotten a little bigger, but he was still the cutest, sweetest pup Lizzie had ever met. She loved his soft puppy fur and his silky ears, and she loved to kiss the little white heart-shaped marking on his chest. Lizzie loved to take Buddy for walks and to teach him new tricks. His latest was roll over, and she loved just lying with him on the couch, patting him while she read a favorite book. Lizzie loved everything about Buddy. But could Lizzie say goodbye to Buddy for a weekend while she went to Camp Bowser with Aunt Amanda and Uncle James? Well, as long as she knew he would be there waiting for her when she got back, yes, she could. "Wow," she said now to Aunt Amanda. "I would love to come to Camp Bowser." "Well, we'll see," her aunt said. "Right now, we have some doggy guests arriving for our party. Want to help me get them settled?" Lizzie got to her feet and dusted off her hands. "Absolutely," she said. Just then, the door to the play area opened. "Amanda, they're here," called Josie, one of the other helpers. 4 dogs came through the door.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.